Hi, I'm Jayme Lewis, and welcome to TheBasis.net. This is the beginning of a 12-episode series called The Basics, and I call it that on purpose because, well, one, it's the first thing that I recommend to all new subscribers when getting started here at TheBasis.net. And also, we're going to be covering a multitude of topics that are going to be extremely beneficial to anyone who's brand new to the bass guitar. Now, even if you're not new to bass, maybe you've been playing for a while, and you might know a lot of this stuff already. That's okay. I still want you to go through this series, and here's the reason why. Number one, just to make sure that you have a strong grasp on the fundamentals of bass playing. And two, this is a crash course on all things bass. So if you hear me say something that you haven't heard of before, or you see something that you haven't seen before, well, now you know what topics to search out next here at the Basis.net archive. Either way, over the next 12 videos, we're going to be covering a multitude of different topics. Things like, how to hold a bass, to how to restring it, how to tune it, basic right and left hand technique, injury prevention, essential music theory, and much, much more. So don't go anywhere. These lessons are going to be monumental in determining the progression of your musical journey from here on out. So stick around. So to get the ball rolling here, I figured we should start from square one, which is, how do I even hold on to a bass? I mean, if you've ever seen anyone play bass, or even just a regular guitar, well, just look at them. They have a strap and they're standing, or they're sitting down and it's on their lap. Pretty self-explanatory, right? Well, actually, it's a little bit more involved than that. Now, what I'm going to do today is I'm going to show you several options for holding your bass in a multitude of different scenarios, and I'll tell you when some of those ways may be advantageous over another. And I'm going to be very thorough, too, because believe it or not, quite often the things that hold us back from progressing further are the simple things that we tend to overlook. So we'll start by playing in a seated position like you see me right now, since many of us play while sitting in a chair, either when we're practicing or when we're recording music in the studio. And we'll also assume for the time being that there's no guitar strap involved, meaning it's just you and your bass. That's it. It's important to sit on the edge of your seat if it's your typical dining room chair kind of thing. But if it's a taller stool or even a smaller seat with no back to it, kind of like a drum throne, then you can sit in the center. Sitting like this promotes good posture and also keeps you from relaxing. When we relax, we're not very attentive, and this can cause us to play sloppy, as well as do some physical damage over time. More on that later. Now, you have two different options here when playing from a seated position. You can balance it on one leg or on the other. So, here's what happens when you play your bass while balancing it on your right leg. It causes me to place my right forearm on the top of the instrument to hold it in place. If I take my arm off the bass, it loses balance. This also causes the instrument to tilt out to my right just a little bit rather than being perfectly parallel to my body. You can also see how my right hand drapes comfortably down in the middle of the plucking area, almost equidistant between the neck and the bridge. So the benefits of holding your bass in this position, resting on your right leg, is that it's comfortable, it's well balanced. I mean, look, I'm not even holding it with my hands. Again, because of this counter pressure that I'm applying with my forearm. It's easy to play in the lower part of the neck as much as it is in the middle part of the neck. And also, again, coming back to this right arm over here, look at where it places my hand. My fingers are just right in front of the string. I'm kind of anchored to the instrument in a way to where I can find the strings and I don't have to go guessing on which one I'm playing. Okay, so what are some of the downsides to holding your bass like this on your right leg? Well, one of them is this repetitive counter pressure that I'm constantly putting my right arm through is gonna wear on me over time. And remember, if I relieve this counter pressure, the bass loses its balance. Like any athlete or even a desk job that just requires repetitive motion over and over and over again, well, we know that that can lead to discomfort, pain, and even chronic medical conditions, especially since, I mean, look at what this is doing to my right wrist by balancing my arm here. We're gonna talk more about that in the right hand technique lesson. And then also, the entire weight of my arm from my shoulder to my elbow to my forearm and my fingers is weighing down on this one part of my forearm. That can cause some serious damage over time. Now, if I just take the bass and switch it from my right leg over to my left leg, you're gonna see some very distinct differences in both the positioning of the bass guitar and my physiology as well. Now the instrument sits parallel to my body instead of leaning outward. It's also much easier to move my right hand to different parts of the body since I don't have to worry about the right arm balancing the instrument. And now you'll also see that it's much easier to play in the middle in higher registers because of where the bass is positioned in relation to my body. Now, of course, there's some downsides here too. And the first one I can think of is it's actually a little bit more difficult to play in the lower register. In fact, look at this big ugly kink that I have in my left wrist as opposed to the one I had in my right wrist when I was playing on the other side. The bass is also making less of a connection with my body and feels a little bit further away. When I was on my right leg, I was essentially hugging the thing. It's resting on my entire side, on my core. Over here, it's just kind of leaning on me, and so I just feel a little bit disconnected from it. Combine that also with the incline angle that we have on the neck now as opposed to the more flat angle, and that can just make people feel like they have less control over the instrument when they're playing on the left leg. So that's everything that I could think of about playing from a seated position. But what about standing up? Well, it's easy, right? Just throw on a strap and stand and you're good to go, right? Well, not quite. There's still some variables here that we need to take into consideration, like strap length, strap thickness, and strap material. I know, so many choices. We're just gonna break these down one at a time. So as far as the strap itself is concerned, anything thick and padded, meaning thick as in wide and thick as in lots of padding, anything like this is gonna be recommended by both myself and many medical physicians as well. And the reasoning is actually quite simple. A thicker padded strap is just gonna make it more comfortable to wear, and having a wider strap actually distributes the weight of the instrument over a larger portion of your shoulder, preventing long-term injuries over time. Because if this was a thinner strap, we're putting the weight of the instrument on smaller portions of the shoulder, which can cause pinched nerves, it can inflame your arthritis, and just do a whole bunch of other things that we really don't even wanna get into. If your strap is lower, it definitely looks cooler. I won't knock it, but it actually makes it harder to play the higher up your neck you move. Look at that big old kink in my left wrist. That's both painful and it makes it difficult to play up here. The opposite side, playing too high, well, A, looks pretty dorky, and B, puts unnecessary strain on your left wrist, elbow, and shoulder, of course, depending on the size of your bass, when you're playing in the lower positions. However, it makes playing up high a breeze and keeps the wrist nice and straight. So if looking really cool is important to you, but you don't want to sacrifice playability in your higher registers, maybe try to find somewhere in the middle to get the best of both worlds. Perhaps try keeping the bass just around the mid-lower part of your belly. Actually, what I recommend is to adjust your strap length so that standing up will keep the bass in the same position as when you're sitting down. So whether I stand or sit, the bass doesn't move at all. So think about it, if you're clocking in hours and hours and hours, feeling it right here, and here's where my hand goes, and here's where this is, and this is where the bass feels, and then you get on stage and all of a sudden it's way down here or it's in a totally different position, you're more than likely gonna play it differently and probably worse. So if you get anything from this video at all, let it be this right here. There are several ways to hold and balance your bass when you play it, and each one of those ways has their own advantages and disadvantages. So which one's the right one? Which one should I actually use? Well, ultimately, that's really up to you. Only you can make that decision based on your particular instrument and the style of music you play and what your practice routine looks like, your scenario, your needs, and all that stuff. But if you want my opinion, and I hope this doesn't sound like a cop-out, I would say all of them. When I perform, my bass can be in any one of these positions that I've mentioned to you, just depending on the particular song or the particular passage. Do I need to play down low or up high or in the middle? Not locking myself into one way of playing makes it really easy to adapt just depending on the scenario. And it's also really practical too, because think about it, if I'm standing up and my legs get tired, well, I just sit down. Now my legs get a rest. But as I'm playing sitting down, my right arm over here starts to hurt after a while. Okay, cool, I move it over to my left leg, right? I'm sharing the load between all these different positions so that no one muscle group or no one joint has to bear all the weight and all the pain, and it'll actually prevent further injury. So that should be more than enough information, probably more information than you ever wanted to know about how to hold your bass. So if this is new to you, maybe just spend a little while playing in each of these positions, or maybe not even playing, just holding it and seeing which one you like more, which one feels more natural to you. Find the ones that work best for you in your playing scenario and your instrument, and start there. Learn those ones first, and then experiment with the other ones as you move forward. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and also click on that subscribe video so you can check out more great videos just like this one. And also be sure to check out my weekly podcast called The Bassist Podcast. All you gotta do is just type in The Bassist wherever podcasts are sold or downloaded or streamed. It's free. I don't know why I said sold. You don't gotta pay anything for it. And when you're ready, go ahead and check out the next lesson in this series called How to Tune Your Bass. Hey, if you like what I do, please click on the subscribe button right here. And if you really like what I do, then click over here to see how affordable it is to join me at thebassist.net. But if you just want the free stuff, then click here to check out whatever YouTube's sophisticated robots think you should watch next. I'm sure they know what's best for you.